climb up here. Friendly? Hi. Oh boy, that looks pretty powerful. We don't want that thing to see us. Absolutely not. I don't need that. Just in case it's trained to kill whoever walks in here. Insurance office key. Sounds interesting. It's getting stuck on the stuff. Another Aldo Facenti. Can we close this door? It can open the door. I don't suppose it would like us hacking this thing. Or breaking in there. Greater Halcyon Insurance Group. Review recent records. Ahmed Birtwistle. Hoping time is stopped when we're doing this. Claim. Loss of gentlemanly honor and good name. I entered into a gentleman's wager with several chaps at Billingsley's regarding the nature and composition of the Spacer's Choice product, tarmac and cheese. I was quite certain the product did contain actual tarmac, and my companions wagered that it surely did not. Lo and behold, investigation into the matter revealed that I had been the victim of a gross misunderstanding. Yet how was I to know what manner of fare common factory workers eat? And how could Spacer's Choice be so irresponsible as to advertise that its product contains tarmac when it when it clearly does not? Oh, damn. The damage to my reputation has been most grievous. I find myself unable to return to my previous haunts for fear of the stares and chuckles that will follow. My honor as a gentleman has been called into question, as has the nature of my relationship with livestock. We've got an end quote here without a... Oh, this is the whole thing. Okay. Resolution denied. Improper form work. Claimant forgot to see the magic word. Magic word. What's the magic word? So, he's wanted to sue them, because the product did not contain tarmac. So he would have preferred it did and ingest it. Right. Fanny Cartwright. Claim, loss of one finger. I've been an assistant saw operator with C&P for 5 years. Most of the blade guards broke last year and management never replaced them. I lost my left ring finger last week as a result. Resolution denied. Negligible damage. Claimant is right-handed, so the magnitude of this loss is minimal. Are you kidding me? Updated claim. Loss of three fingers. The saw I was working... Oh, she can't write. Came loose yesterday in account of CMP skipping reluctant maintenance checks. The accident took two fingers from my right hand and a other from my left. Resolution denied. Self-disqualification. Claimant was missing a finger from a previous incident and should not have been operating sharp machinery. Updated claim. Loss of four fingers. Oh, boy. Let's see if I can decode this. The late shift left several crates and... Curd and whey? When they felt no ked me into the... For my remaining two fingers. Resolution denied. Claim unintelligible. My God. Filed on behalf of C&P. Claim loss of one worker. Assistant saw operator 16. F. Cartwright. Lost several digits due to carelessness and negligence. She failed to heed prominently posted warnings about the state of our safety equipment, and her resultant injuries have decreased our factory's productivity and led to multiple stress headaches for management as we struggled to reshuffle worker schedules around 16J. Resolution approved. Oh my God. I guess you could figure that I managed to bar the door and kept it out. Well, you guys left the room. They went downstairs while I was reading all that? He's steps a little out of the way there. Is it coming back yet?
Great work.
Hope it doesn't come down here. It shows up as aggressive. Sublight ID cartridge. An ID cartridge belonging to a Sublight employee. Oh! The holographic shroud developed by Phineas Wells uses the biometric information stored on a corporate identity cartridge to construct a crude holographic disguise. You cannot appear as a specific individual, but will pass as a corporate employee from distance. Awesome. Oh, good for a free drink at the Antioch Bar in Fallbrook. Sublight storage key. Unlocks the sublight storage room that's built into Fallbrook's natural caverns. Now, I'm worried about this thing, not that we can't defeat it, but that if we attack and destroy it, that the entire town will become hostile to us. That concerns me right now. It's no longer showing up as hostile. Oh. Hi.
Welcome to the offices of the Greater Halcyon Insurance Group, Halcyon's premier provider of life and disaster-related insurance. I'm obligated to inform you that our coverage does not extend to incidents deemed to result from negligence, criminal activity, or dullness of mind.
Speaking of dullness of mind, I can't help but be glad that you did not realize I didn't come through the front door. Dullness of mind?
Some people, but no one in this office, I assure you, might call it stupidity.
Obviously too common an ailment for insurance to cover.
Got it.
So, what kind of insurance package can I interest you in? We're running a special on dismemberment policies. Buy one, get one half off.
Funny. Why is your office on Monarch?
We're not on Monarch. For all practical and tax-related purposes, this office is an official enclave of Byzantium.
Huh? Why?
Legally speaking, corporations are not allowed to operate on Monarch. But financially speaking, there are certain costs to running a business from within Byzantium's walls. So while our official address is in the city, and while our office here is technically an extension of that address, we found it more expedient to conduct our key operations here. So we can... what's the phrase? Pass savings to the consumer, of course.
So you're dodging the authorities.
We prefer to think of it as chasing the savings. Turns out that not having to pay kickbacks, fines, and rent in the most expensive city in Halcyon improves our liquidity. Plus... Sublight keeps this place running remarkably well, and they sure drive business our direction.
What can you tell me about your insurance policies?
Plenty. As my boss likes to say, there's a policy for every situation and an exclusion for every policy. We've insured unusually expressive eyebrows, outrageous statements, disastrous marriages.
Wait, who gets their eyebrows insured?
Usually character actors or corporate execs with menacing stares.
Who would get an outrageous statement insured?
That policy is almost exclusively for our corporate clientele. In the unlikely event they make a claim about a product that turns out to be less than accurate, they need some kind of protection against the damage to their sales and reputation.
Okay. Disastrous marriages?
Those are mostly for top rungers in Byzantium who have a lot of social and financial capital wrapped up in their marriage contracts. There's one for your beloved eloping with her sibling. Your beloved eloping with their sibling, scandalous rumors forcing you apart, the revelation of a secret love child. We try to cover every possible hazard to domestic bliss.
Okay, I'm not gonna be needing any of that. That's all I needed to know, though.
One thing's for sure. You won't find better policy protection against sudden lunar implosions anywhere in Halcyon.
Sudden lunar implosions. Okay, well that's all then. How much money do I have now? Not that much. Oh. I'll come back. CMP. Hi.
Keep walking, Rusty.
I got into this place not through the front door. Wouldn't you like to know how? Sadly for you, I will not tell you. Dry goods and sundry.
Booze like this leads to two things. Bumpin' uglies and brawling.
Brawling uglies.
They do not produce derelict entertainment such as this on Byzantium, I assure you.
Good to know. Have I gone in?
Yes. Knock, knock.
Go away, White.
That's not how the game works. I say knock, knock, like I'm on the outside of a door.
If I've been there.
You say,
I swear to the architect, I will punch your lamps out.
Oh, having a rough day?
I lost a shipment out for delivery. Barely made it out. Marauders got Keely.
Ooh, Catherine is gonna flay the skin from your fingers.
Keely?
I know.
Sounds painful.
I don't have time for this.
Do you have time for the skin flayed from your fingers?
Move along.
Alright. Have I been in here?
This is Reginald's stuff, all right, but it looks like he's not home. Let's search the room. Try to figure out where he's gone.
Okay. It's stealing, though, so you guys have to come in so I can just look at stuff. Did you shush me? Necklaces. You can examine that. Reginald Cheney's Gold Planning Log. Day 152. Location. Bunch of coordinates. Condition. Fair. Report. I can't believe I'm still stuck in this law-forsaken town, but at least I think I may have finally found a spot with promise. Down the tunnel on the riverbank outside of town. Produced one nugget and two teeth. I wonder if I can find a dentist who'd pay something for the teeth. Cheney. One nugget and two teeth.
Sounds like Cheney's gone gold panning down on the river. I guess even scholars need to find ways to make ends meet in exile.
True.
As always, I am at your disposal. Anything you'd like to discuss?
No. I guess we're gonna have to go look for him. After we finish what we're doing here. Duncan Ellie and Leanna Reed. Guns, 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 and ammo developed. Ooh. Is that like candy or something? Oh, those little rocks. Hi.
My dry goods come 75% guaranteed mold free. Was that 75% mold free? No rubbernecking. Make a buy or move on.
Jeez. Well, he's got stuff. We can't afford it right now. Do I have any?
I test every product myself to assure maximum customer satisfaction. If you doubt it, I can show you my lower back rash. No rubbernecking. Make a buck.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I can buy stuff for quests. Can't afford it. Huh. I forgot about the junk. I'm trying to get a little money here. kit. All right, what else? How much money do I have now? My bits are that much? Sweet. I can buy both of these sublight data pads. The personal data pad of a sublight contractor. When a sublight contractor dies on a job, their aggressively non-sentimental teammates sell all of their possessions to maximize profits. This could explain why most sublight contractors tend to work alone. It's hard to partner with somebody who often weighs how valuable your corpse might be. Damaged UDL data pad. A corporate data pad with UDL branding. From the plasma burns and specks of blood marring the device, its previous owner refused to part with it until, to quote, over my dead body. Down on their luck, smugglers will often purchase old data pads in the hope of finding clues to a forgotten cache of goods they can sell. Sweet. So these are quest things. I guess we get quests by buying them. The screen is cracked, and most of the keys are non-functional, fused together from plasma damage. All but a few entries are unreadable. Of those remaining, only snippets can be viewed. Entry number 1. Corporal Sauber, you are reassigned effective immediately. Must report to Site Safety Commander Sanders by 1600 HST. Transport provided by non-corporate contractor. Reliable. Proceed overland to research... Face something east, town designation Fallbrook. Entry number 2. Kind of bleep hole facility is this. I'm never accepting a promotion again unless it comes with a gilded haste. Chastity? Chastity keeps losing her damn key card. Expects me to find it for her. Not her swain? At least Powell is easy on the eyes. Entry number 2. Wrapped alarm went off again before I got a chance to try the weapon. Never seen anything like it. Chasta used it for a damn prank. Now Sanders is going to lock it up. And I'll never something. Perfect for crowd control. Easy to maintain order in the townships once they get their hands on glue. Okay. Sublight data pad. This data pad contains the personal journal of Mercer Cole, a low-level sublight contractor. Most entries pertain to slagging his teammates while complaining about bad pay contracts. The last entry reads, "Can't believe we found Alavite gas." Oh. Vitae gas, yeah, in a hibernated Rizzo lab out in the dust pack. Lavite? Alavite? Knee, whatever it's spelled, it's worth a ton. Who'd use that to make candy? Looks like old Girlie's hunch is gonna prove out. Not that I'll ever tell her so, the way she goes primal at the slightest hint of criticism. Too much product for us to transport. Gonna need a ship to smuggle this off-world. Probably need Lilia Hagen to send a team. No way Ms. Mallon can handle this job out of Fallbrook. Been working on Remy, playing him with the pale kale ale he likes. Applying him, sorry. Figure if I get him nice and sloshed, he'll tell me the password into that place. Did some exploring while he and Gertie were testing the Alawiti gas. Alpha Vitae. Found an old elevator shaft with a lab coat modded into a hidey spot for some dandified weapon. Thing's probably worth enough to make me a right top runger after I go back for it. Old Mercer's getting himself to Byzantium. You can bet on it. Can't let Remy or Gertie find out about it. Gertie would go all full burn and demand I split the profits. Remy, he'd probably send me to the boneyard and keep it for himself. Weapons from the wild. Okay, acquire the science weapon on Scylla Monarch and in the abandoned lab. Huh. Cool. Liana.
No refunds, no exchanges, no returns. And no whining about it either.
But I love it too.
You buy it. Store policy.
Who's the top dog in these parts?
Town Sublight owned and run. Caters to a variety of clientele. The one you want to avoid pissing off the most is Catherine. Prove bad for her business, and she'll kneecap you without a second thought.
Hmm. So a town built in the Silent Mountain. You don't see one of those every day, unless you live here.
Yeah, and? Do I look like the city planner?
Yes.
I wasn't exactly consulted on the blueprints when Catherine started building out Fallbrook.
Should have been.
But now that you mention it, I reckon she had her reasons to hide us.
From who? Monarch is a lawless land.
We got smugglers, outlaws, mavericks, and Byzantium socialites flying in and out of Fallbrook all the time. Why openly spin in the board's eye?
Hmm. No, I think you're not telling me the whole story.
It might be that you're right. But I got no reason to trust you with the truth, now do I? Maybe if you were a better friend to Sublight.
Hmm.
Ask me again if you're standing with Sublight and proves, and I'll feel more obliged to answer.
It's because my status went down, isn't it? Or it's already like that and it didn't help. Alright, let me see what we got for sale. Not that I can afford it, but... Okay, so no quests. I wonder if we've missed anything else for quests. Because I just ended up there kind of mistakenly. Heavy ammo. We do need it. I can't get it. I'm just gonna wait. I can't get it all. That's unacceptable, mister. Maybe we can get some, though. Nothing much back here. What's with this stuff? Huh. There's skulls and stuff. What the hell? Why do you have skulls and... mannequin hands? Jewelry? Hi.
Oh, I beg your pardon. Can you not see I'm walking here?
You don't look like you're walking. You're actually sitting down.
Physically, you mean? In my mind, I have traveled galaxies.
Oh.
Well, it is of no consequence, I assure you. I shall embark shortly with my legs.
To where?
I'm not entirely decided. If I'm being honest, I think I'd fancy a visit to Tartarus. So long as it's under the shield of my fantastical imagination.
Okay then, bye. Okay. Is it possible this guy might not see me because he's in the depths of his fantastical imagination? Construction gear. That's some pretty good armor. We have better, though.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
Nothing at all.
I don't want any trouble out of you.
I thought you were lost in your own imagination.
Pardon me, you're distracting the magnificent journey of my mind. I was galaxies away, being ripped asunder in the depths of a black hole.
That you like that?
What an excruciating and exquisite experience.
Wait, what?
Nothing at all, I assure you. I tend to ramble during my daily walks. If there's no further excitement to be had, I suppose I shall go for a soak beneath the medicinal waterfall. Perhaps I'll slice my heel open on a rock. Nothing like the physicality of pain to make you feel alive.
What are you into? Okay. I kind of wish you would just leave so I can get into all this stuff. Like, actually physically leave, and then you could slice your foot open, whatever the hell you want to do. What did I pick up? Oh, some junk, right? How much money do I have now? I have enough. Malin's House of Hospitality. Came from here, right? That's the way in. Before I go here, I'm gonna check out these other buildings. This, I'm thinking, might go downstairs. Alright, so I'm gonna wait for Malin here.
Keep walking, Rungleech. What are you looking at?
A rung leech.
Ain't in the mood to chat.
We are powerful enough as it is. Go away. We are powerful enough as it is. Go away.
Pauseful? I'll be back.
Always imagined Fallbrook would be...
cleaner, fancier, stocked with better booze.
Cheaper. I've emptied 14-bit carts in the last 2 hours.
That's because you've got a terrible tell. Whenever you're lying, your right eye twitches like mad.
Huh.
It most certainly does not.
Twitching.
I wouldn't steer you wrong, friend. See? There it goes again.
Carry on.
Carry on.
Carry on yourself. Nobody in here? Okay, guys. Still empty. Mr. Power, two of them. Okay. Awesome. That is how we make some money. We can get a player home here, apparently. Requires a domicile key. Good. I don't need my reputation going down anymore. I don't see anybody around here, actually. Oh, that's the way down to the tunnels we're not doing yet. Hell no. Hi.
Only thing worse than the swill they're selling is the service.
Mm-hmm.
I'll thank you to check your weapons at the door.
I'm not doing that.
If you're feeling like the civilized type, the waterfall's a good spot to wash your clothes.
Oh, yeah. I'm not so sure if I was washing my armor in a waterfall. Guess we'd be remiss if we didn't check it out, though.
My bet's on temptation.
Only thing worse than the swill they're selling is the service.
It's back here. I thought that guy was on fire. Reginald?
What do you want?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, hey, Victor
that,
Max.
That Reginald.
What are you doing on Monarch? I thought scienticians ain't welcome here.
Scientician?
Haven't you heard? Everyone's welcome here. It's a fucking worker's paradise. But you wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
Oops.
Never worked a day in your miserable life. You're just a parasite, living off my goodwill. Well, guess what? My goodwill's exhausted, along with my temper.